मैंने स्टार्ट किया मैंने टाइम की 2 दिन की।
Good afternoon, students. Welcome to the webinar sessions conducted by Telangana State Residential Educational Institution Society. This is A. Sandhata working as PGD in Physical Science in TSR School and Junior College located at Zairabad in Hotike. Now, today we are going to start a new chapter, Refraction of Light at Curved Surfaces. Yes, now we know that when a light ray okay, when a light ray or a light wave, it strikes the surface of an object, the light can be absorbed by the object, it can be reflected or it can be transmitted. Okay, so when a light ray, it strikes the surface of an object, what can happen, children? It can be absorbed, it can be reflected, or transmission can also occur. Now, let me ask you a question. Now, can we find an object in a room which is totally dark? Yes, now can we search for an object, okay, when there is complete darkness in the room? Will it be possible for us? No, it is difficult for us to search, or we can say it is impossible. Sometimes it is impossible for us to identify an object, okay, or search an object when there is complete darkness in the room. Now can you say why? You know why? We know that we are able to see an object only when the reflected ray from that object reaches the eye. Yes, we are able to see an object only when the reflected ray, okay, from the surface of the object reaches the eye of the observer. Until and unless the reflected ray reaches the eye of the observer will not be able to see an object. Is it clear? Now what do you observe in this figure? We observe an amazing, a beautiful rainbow in the sky. Now, did you anytime get a doubt? How does this rainbow form? Yes, did you have that doubt in your mind, children? Do you know how it is formed? Let us see. Now here we know that rainbow is generally observed in the sky after the rainfall. Yes, so what do we have in the atmosphere? We have water droplets. Yes, now let us take a single, or let us consider a single water droplet. Now this is a water droplet. Okay, now observe carefully. Now here you have a sun. Yes, from the sun what are we getting? We're getting light rays. Yes, so when there's a light ray, it falls at the surface of the water droplet. Now let us assume that this is having two surfaces. This is first surface and this is the another surface. Now when there's a light ray, it falls at the surface of the water droplet. Now you can clearly observe that it is not going in the same path. It is not moving, or it is not traveling in the same path, right? It is getting bent. Yes, the light ray, when it strikes the surface of the raindrop, what is happening? It is getting bent. Now that bending of light, we call it as a refraction. Okay, bending of light is called as a refraction. Now what do you observe? The light ray, when it strikes the surface of the water droplet, it undergoes a refraction. And what do you observe here? We observe that the white light is splitting into its seven constituent colors. Okay, it is splitting into its seven constituent colors. That splitting of light into its constituent colors is called as dispersion of light. Yes, so what do you observe here? A refraction is happening and also dispersion is also happening. Yes, now once this refracted rays, when they strike the surface, the other surface of the raindrop, what is happening? What do you observe? They're not entering into the air, they're getting reflected into the water droplet. They're getting reflected. What is happening here? Total internal reflection takes place. What is total internal reflection? When the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, when the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, the reflected ray, okay, the ray, it gets reflected back into the denser medium. That is, it never enters into the rarer medium. So what is total internal reflection, children? Total internal reflection is nothing but when the angle of incidence is greater than the critical angle, the light ray gets reflected into the denser medium. It never enters into the rarer medium. This is called as total internal reflection. Now here I have used the term denser medium. Now already this you have learned in your lower sections, rarer medium, denser medium. Yes, rarer medium is nothing but the medium in which the speed of the light is less. Okay, denser medium is nothing but the medium in which the speed of the light is less. Okay, now here, so here what is happening? A refraction has happened, dispersion has occurred, and also total internal reflection is taking place. Now once the rays that are reflected reaches the first surface, okay, of the water droplet, what happens? They again get refracted. Is that clear, children? It again gets refracted. Okay, so what are we observing here? We are observing that refraction is taking place, dispersion is taking place, total internal reflection, and also refraction is again taking place. Because of this, okay, we are able to observe a beautiful rainbow in the sky. Is that clear, children? Next. Now, what do you observe here? We observe a prism here. Yes, here also we see that a ray of light is falling on the surface of a prism. Okay, and it is getting refracted, that is, it is getting bent, and again dispersion is also taking place here. Now here, now this is what all of us know, that it is a diamond. Yes, all of us are familiar with the diamond. So what do you observe when the light falls on a diamond? What happens? It shines. Yes, it looks very beautiful. So do you know what is the reason behind that? Here also, when the light enters into the diamond, it gets refracted and it undergoes total internal reflection. Okay, that is, when the light strikes the diamond, what happens here? It undergoes refraction and total internal reflection takes place here. Yes, so what do we observe here in the prism? In this example also refraction is taking place. In this example also refraction is taking place. Now observe this picture, children. Now this you might have observed some people doing like a magic trick. What do? They take a glass, okay, and they keep a coin inside it. And they ask us to say whether we are able to observe the coin or not. Okay, from the position from where we are sitting, sometimes the coin will not be visible to us. Yes, then what that person will do? He starts to add water. When he starts adding water, what happens? From the position where we are sitting, from the same position, we will be able to see the coin. Now, in the first case, when there was no water, we were not able to see the coin from the position where we were sitting. In the second case, when water was poured into the glass or the tumbler, the coin became visible. What is the reason behind it? Before also, coin was there. Before pouring water, coin was there, but it was not visible to us. Why? Can you give the reason? Let us see. Okay. Now, as discussed earlier, we know that until and unless the reflected rays reaches the eye of the observer, the object cannot be seen. Okay. Now, here you can see that here you have two different mediums, right? Here you have water, which is liquid. Here you have air, which is gas. Now, here you see the reflected rays from the coin when they reach the surface. Okay. When they reach the surface, what happens? They get bent. You can see that they are not going in this straight path. They are not moving in a straight line, right? They are bending. Okay, they are bending. And one thing is, when the light ray bends, what is happening here? The ray is reaching our eyes, right? Now, since the ray is reaching our eyes, we are able to see the image of the coin, and it appears to be raised from the initial position. Okay, now the eye of the observer, okay, the eye of the observer, that is whoever is observing the coin from a certain position, okay, the eye of the observer cannot recognize the zigzag path of the light. It always identifies the light moving in a straight line. Okay, now we know that some n number of rays will be reflecting from the surface of the coin. Yes, for simplification, only one ray is shown here. We know that there are several rays. Yes, now when all these rays, they get refracted, they get bent at this interface, that is at the surface, what happens here? We're able to see the reflected rays are reaching our eyes and we're able to see the object. Yes, now, as learned in the earlier classes, now, as discussed just now, that the eyes identify the rays coming from a straight line. Okay, so when we extend this refracted rays backwards, that is when we extrapolate these refracted rays backwards, what happens here? All the refracted rays will meet at a point, right? So at that point of intersection only, image will be formed. So this is a point where all the refracted, extended, which are extended backwards, meet. That is the reason why image is formed here. Okay, so this is the real position, right? This is the actual position where the coin is. But here, this is the what? Image of the coin. This position is called as apparent position. What is that called as, children? Apparent position. Okay, now did you understand why the coin appears to be raised? Yes. Okay, observe these figures. You can see that the ray from the coin is reaching the eye. So the observer is able to see the coin. Here in this figure B, you can see that the rays which are reflected from the surface of the coin, they are not reaching the eye of the observer. When the reflected rays, they are not reaching the eye of the observer, observer cannot see the coin. Yes, it is obvious, right? Now, when the water is poured, we did not change the position of the coin. Coin is at the same position, but here in the figure C, what do you observe? When water is added, the rays are reaching the eye of the observer. Why? Because of refraction at the surface. Okay, this boundary. Okay. At this boundary, what is happening, children? Refraction is taking place. Now, since the ray is getting refracted, now since the ray is getting bent, that is reaching our eyes. Okay. Now, when we extrapolate these refracted rays backwards, they all will meet at a point, and at that point of intersection, images form, and we're able to observe the image. Is that clear? So here also, what do we observe here? We observe a glass in which a pencil is placed. Yes, take a glass, place a pencil, and add water to it. So what do you observe here? We observe that the pencil is broken. Is it really broken? Do you think so? Now, did you ever done this activity, children? If you have never done, try it once. Okay, take a glass, keep pencil in the empty glass, start pouring water. So after you pour water, you observe that suddenly the pencil appears to be broken. Why? Here also the same refraction phenomena takes place. Okay, the rays that are coming from the pencil, after they reach the surface, they get bent, they get refracted, and they reach the eye of the observer. Now, when these refracted rays are extended, extrapolated backwards, they meet at a point, and at that point, the image will be formed. Okay. Here also, what do you observe in this figure? In this figure, a boy is standing and observing at the fish, which is swimming in the pond. Did you ever observe, children? Yes. What do you observe here in this figure? A boy is standing and he is observing the fish in the pond. Now, here also you see that actually the fish is in this position, whereas to the boy, it appears to be here in this position. Why? Because the reflected ray, when it reaches the surface, okay, it gets refracted. It gets refracted. Now, since the ray is reaching the eye of the child, he is able to see the image, not the actual fish. See the image of the fish. Is that clear? So what is refraction, students? Refraction is nothing but the phenomenon of change in the position. Sorry, the phenomenon of change in the path or direction of light passing from one medium to another medium. Whenever light passes from one medium to another medium, what is happening? It is change path. It is changing its direction. So that change in the path or direction of light, when it moves from one medium to another medium, is called as refraction of light. Is that clear? Now, why does the direction of the light change when it moves from one medium to another medium? Did you get that question? Why? Because the speed of the light changes. Speed of the light changes when it enters from one medium to another medium. What happens here? What happens here, children? Yes? Direction of the light changes. Is that clear? Now, we can also define refraction as it is the phenomenon of bending of light from its original path on entering another medium. So it is also nothing but bending of light from its original path when it enters into another medium. Is that clear?
Welcome to the webinar session.
And it can also be defined as bending of light at the interface of two different mediums. Bending of light at the interface of two different mediums. Now, what is interface? Interface is nothing but the surface separating the two phases of matter, each of which may be solid, liquid, or a gas. Okay, interface is nothing but the surface separating the two phases of matter. Okay, and the refraction takes place at the interface. So we can also call this interface as a boundary. Okay, so but a boundary. Okay. So interface is nothing but the surface separating the two phases of matter, each of which, that is, the phases of matter can be solid, liquid, or a gas. Is that clear? And this refraction occurs at the boundary of the two media. Yes. So I think all of you are familiar with these words. Yes, rarer medium, denser medium, refractive index. Yes, what is rarer medium, children? A mean speed of light is more is known as rarer medium. Is that clear? A medium in which the speed of light is more is known as rarer medium. What is denser medium? Denser medium is nothing but a medium in which the speed of light is less. Then we know that when the light ray enters from a rarer medium to denser medium, listen carefully. When a light ray enters from rarer medium to denser medium, the refracted ray moves. This already you have learned in your lower classes. Yes, when the light ray enters from rarer medium to denser medium, what happens? It moves towards the normal. And when the light ray moves from denser medium to rarer medium, listen. When the light ray enters from denser medium to rarer medium, the refracted ray moves away from the normal. Okay, remember this, children. And what is this refractive index? A refractive index is nothing but the ratio between the speed of light in a medium to speed of light in a vacuum. Is that clear? The ratio between the speed of light in a medium to speed of light in a vacuum is called as refractive index or index of refraction. And the speed of light depends on the properties of the medium. So did you get an idea of what is then rarer medium, denser medium, refractive index? Yes, rarer medium is nothing but a medium in which the speed of the light is less. A refractive index is nothing but it is a measure of how much a ray is bending. Okay, it is a measure of bending of a ray of light when it moves from one another medium. Well, observe this figure, children. Observe this figure. Now here you see that here we have a source of light. Yes, from this source of light we are considering only one light ray. Okay, now this is what it is, a surface. It is a that is separating two different media. One is air and the other is water. Now air is one medium, water is another medium, right? Okay, so when this light ray, it falls or it strikes the interface, what happens here? What we have discussed just now, refraction takes place at the interface, that is at the boundary. Okay, as soon as the incident it strikes at the interface, it undergoes refraction. Okay, it changes its direction. Why? Because the speed of the light changes. Okay, so we know that air is a rarer medium, water is a denser medium. Yes, and we also know that when the light ray enters from rarer medium to denser, the refracted ray moves or bends towards the normal. Okay, and an angle is formed between the normal and the refracted ray. That clear, students? Okay, so when the light ray enters from rarer medium to denser medium, what is happening? Refracted ray moves towards the normal. Okay, then what happens when the light ray travels from denser medium to rarer medium? So when the light ray travels from denser to rarer medium, that is from water to air, what happens? Refracted ray, it moves away from the normal. Is that clear? Well, let us discuss an activity about the refraction of light at curved surfaces. Now, what are the materials that are required here? We require an empty glass tumbler and also a white paper on which an arrow is drawn. Is that clear, students? Okay, take a white paper, take a black marker and draw an arrow 4 centimeters length. Then what you do is give that paper to your friend and you stand in front of the glass and ask your friend to place the arrow on the paper behind the glass. Okay, let your friend place this arrow which is drawn on the paper behind the glass. Okay, and you observe by standing in the front of the glass. So what do you observe? The size of the arrow is decreased. We observe a diminished image. Diminished image is diminished in the sense decrease in the size. Okay, we observe a diminished image. Okay, so what is the procedure? Draw an arrow of length 4 centimeters using a black sketch pen on a thick sheet of paper. Take an empty cylindrical shaped transparent vessel such as a glass tumbler. Keep it on the table. Ask your friend to bring that sheet of paper on which arrow was drawn behind the vessel, looking at it from the other side. Care should be taken that the arrow mark is in the horizontal position. Now what you do is ask your friend to pour water. To stand in the same position and ask your friend to start pouring water. So when your friend starts pouring water, when he completes pouring water into the glass, you stand in the same position and observe at the image of the So when you observe at the image of the arrow, what do you observe, children? We see that the size of the image is enlarged. We see an enlarged image and inverted image. Inverted means reversed. So here you can see that in this figure, the head of the arrow is pointing towards the left. Yes or no? If you can observe, right? The head of the arrow is pointing towards the left. Whereas when we look at the image of the arrow, the head of the arrow is pointing towards right. So this is nothing but an inverted image. Okay, so when water is poured, okay, and when the image of the arrow is observed, which kind of image is formed, children? Enlarged and inverted image. Okay, so ask your friend to fill the vessel with water. Look at the figure of the arrow from the same position as before. Okay, so when the vessel was empty, the image formed was diminished image. When the vessel is filled with water, image formed was enlarged and inverted image. Is that clear? Yes. So now when the vessel is filled with water, there is a kind of phase between the two different media. Now here, the vessel, this is the vessel, right? Here you have water, outside you have air. So between air and water, what do we have? We have an interface. Okay, we have a curved interface. So when the water, there is a curved interface between two different media, that is air and water. So let us assume that the refractive indices of both water and glass are the same. Okay, the refractive indices of both water and glass are same. Really, they are not equal, but let us assume that the refractive indices of both water and also the glass are same. Okay, now this is the water, now this is glass, right? We have assumed that the refractive index of glass and the refractive index of water is same. Okay, now this is a curved surface. Yes, now what happens to a ray that is incident on a curved surface separating the two media? Now this is water, right? Side we have air, okay, air and water. There's a curved surface. The question is, what happens to a ray that is incident on a curved surface separating the two media? Let us discuss. Now before we enter into that topic, let us first recollect certain terms. Okay, one is curvature. Okay, what is center of curvature, students? Yes, what is center of curvature? We know now this is a curved surface, right? The curved surface is nothing but it is a part of a sphere. Yes, the curved surface is a part of a sphere, and the center of that sphere is called as center of curvature. That surface is a part of a sphere, and the center of that sphere is called as center of curvature. And here, the center of the curved surface. Now, this is a curved surface, and this is the center of the curved surface. The center of the curved surface is called as pole. What it is called as, children? It is called as pole. And the line joining pole and the center of curvature is called as principal axis. The line joining pole and center of curvature is called as principal axis. And what is normal then? Any line, listen carefully, any line drawn from the center of curvature to any point on the curved surface is nothing but normal. Okay? I hope all of you remember. Okay, so what is center of curvature? The center of the sphere of which curved surface is a part is called as center of curvature. Then what is normal, children? Any line drawn from the center of curvature to a point surface becomes normal to the curved surface at that point. What is pole? The center of the curved surface is called as pole of the curved surface. What is principal axis? The line that joins the center of curvature is called as principal axis. Okay, we know that as in the case of plane surfaces, a ray will bend towards the normal if it travels from a radar to a denser medium, and it bends away from the normal if it travels from a denser to a radar medium. The question is, what happens to a ray that travels along this and through the center of curvature? Now here you can see, now this is the curved surface, this is one medium and this is the other medium. Yes, this is center of curvature, this is pole. The line joining pole and center of curvature is called as principal axis. The question was, what happens to a ray that travels along the principal axis and through the center of curvature? Now here you can see that a ray is moving along the principal axis. So can you see how it is moving, children? Is it bending or is it moving in the same direction? It is moving in the same path. That is, it is not getting deviated. It is not changing, right? Okay. So the ray that moves along the principal axis moves in the same path. It does not get deviated. And what happens to the ray which moves through the center of curvature? Yes, moves to the center of curvature also will not get deviated. It also moves in the same path. Why? Why? Because according to Snell's law, the ray which travels normal drawn to the surface does not deviate from its path. Now we have seen, yes, that is, any line drawn from the center of curvature to any point on the curved surface is called as normal. Now we know that this is also along normal and this ray is also moving along normal. Now since they are moving along the normal which is drawn to the surface, their path. Okay, so the ray that travels along the principal axis does not deviate from its path, and also the ray that travels through the center of curvature also does not deviate from its path. So the question is, what happens to a ray traveling parallel to the principal axis? But now we have discussed what happens to a ray which moves along the principal axis, right? Now the question is, what happens to a ray traveling parallel to the principal axis? Now observe this figure A. Now this is a curved surface. The surface, it is concave or convex? It is a convex surface. Yes, and this is one medium and this is another medium. Okay, this is a denser medium and this is a rarer medium. Okay, now we see that a ray is moving parallel to the principal axis. Okay, a ray is moving parallel to the principal axis. So when it moves parallel to the, when it strikes at the convex surface, what happens here? You can see that it is getting deviated. That is, the ray is moving parallel to principal axis and it is moving from a rarer medium to a denser medium. Yes, we know that when a light ray moves from one medium to another medium, what happens, children? It changes its direction. Yes, it undergoes refraction. Here also, when the light ray moves from a rarer medium to a denser medium, what happens here? It changes its direction and the refracted ray, it is moving towards the normal. Okay, the incident ray that on the surface and it is, and which is moving from rarer to denser medium, here it undergoes refraction. Okay, and this refracted ray, what happens? It moves towards the normal. Okay, look at this figure B. Okay, now here also, incident rays striking the convex surface. Okay, the incident ray is falling on the convex surface, and here in this case, it is moving from denser to rarer medium. And we know that when the light ray moves from denser to rarer medium, what happens? It will move away. That is, the refracted ray moves away from the normal. Okay, now observe this figure C. Now this is which surface, students? It is a conic surface, and the ray is moving parallel to the principal axis. Yes, when the ray is moving parallel to the principal axis, and also it is moving from denser medium to a rarer medium. Okay. Now what happens when it moves from denser to rarer medium? Obviously, it will move, the refracted ray, it moves away from the normal. Okay.
This is the
line. It represents what, students? It represents normal. Here also observe this figure.
Madam, I pay the madam.
Just 2 minutes, sir.
Okay.
Here also, light is falling on the concave surface. So when the light falls on the concave surface, when it is moving from rarer medium, what happens, students? It will move towards the normal. Okay. Now, in the figure A, and also the figure C, we observe that the refracted ray is intersecting, it is falling on the principal axis at certain point. Yes, and when we observe B and D, what do you observe? That is, it is moving away, right? It is moving away, the refracted ray is moving away from the principal axis. It is moving away from the principal axis, it is not falling. Where image will be formed then? That is, we need to extend this refracted ray backwards. So when we extend this refracted ray backwards, what happens, students? It will intersect the principal axis at certain point. Okay, here also, extend this ray refracted. When we extend this refract backwards, it will also meet the principal axis at certain point. Is that clear? So if the figures, in the figures A and C, it reaches a particular point on the principal axis. In the figures B and C, the refracted. Okay, in the figures B and D, refracted rays move away from the principal axis. Now, when the refracted rays in the figures B and D are extended backwards along the way, the extended ray, it intersects the principal axis at some point. The point where the refracted ray intersects the axis in all the above cases is called as focal point. Is that clear, children? Focal point. What is focal point? The point where refracted ray intersects the axis in all the above cases. Take these questions. Okay.
Madam,
the first question is, what is refraction? Second is, define the following terms: rarer medium, denser medium, center of curvature, pole. Third is, what happens to a ray that travels along the principal axis and through the center of curvature? The fourth question is refractiveness. I hope all of you will answer these questions. Let us meet tomorrow with new topic. Thank you.
But I believe.